Let us see some of the common list methods in the lists. So there are number of methods for lists, but we will at least cover how to add delete items from them. All of the lists method can be found on the Python's documentation, and how to find all the methods I will be showing you, don't worry. Let us create a list first to play it around. Let us say the same Peter, John, and let us give some values 55 33 44 33. So this is our list to print out. So now we can also loop the lists using for loop for I in L, print the value of I. So like this we can print them. So let us now discuss about, so as I have previously discussed, whenever you are creating a variable, you are calling it as an object. This is an object of a class, and which is the class? Index is the class. So generally we are telling we are creating an index. So that means we are creating an object of the class index. So objects always can access the methods. So let us see some of the methods. So we have like L dot append. This method will add the value to the list. Let us say Williams. So now there is a typo error, L dot append. Let us say Williams. Now see here, Williams is added. And there is one more method, L count. So we don't know how many times 33 appears, suppose. So we can count. So 33 is 3 times. So 1, 2, 3. We can find the index also using L dot index. We don't know the index, but we know the value inside it. Let us find the index of John. So index of John is 0 and 1. 1 is the index. And we can also remove the value. Let us remove John. L dot. There is a method called remove, which will remove the value from the list. Let us remove John. So successfully we have removed the John. Like this, we have one more function, short. Let us see first reverse. So what this will do, this will reverse the list. Let us print. So this is how we will reverse the elements inside the list. And there is again one more method called L dot sort. So short should contain only integer or like or the string values. So there is a method called pop, which will returns last element, then remove it from the list. Let us see the method pop. See, it is giving Peter. The last element is Peter. Now let us see, and Peter is removed. So if you want to remove the last one, it will show you which one it is removing, and it will directly remove it. So these are all the methods available to play around with the lists. So to find what are the elements inside the, or what are the methods available for the list. So as I said earlier, print L and dot and wait for a second. So this will show you all the methods available. You can short, reverse, you can remove, pop, insert, index, extend, count. The count will give the count number. So like this you can use the number of occurrence of x. Let us see count. We have seen the count, no, right? Let us see one more time. Count, if you say, if you want to see whether now there is a Peter or not. 0. There is no Peter inside the list. So because if you have a big list like 1000, elements inside the list. You can see whether the required parameter or required element is inside the list or not using this count. So we can also use it in for loop as we have seen. And so this is little bit about lists. Slowly we will be learning more about lists when we go into the further sections, like when we are learning object oriented programming in Python. So until then, keep practicing. So keep playing with all these methods available. Like when you click L dot, you will be a pop-up comes, all these methods, press up key or down key to select this. So I want to give one more trick. Suppose you have created lot of variables, A is equal to B is equal to, and you have printed the value of A, B, list one which here doesn't available. So you don't know, once we come into some programming, you don't know what are all the variables you have declared. You can look once you by going up, or there is a small trick. We have a dir function and brackets. Don't write anything inside the bracket and press enter. So these are all the variables we have created. We have created A, B, I, L. L is for list, I we have used in the for loop. Now we can see what is inside the I. So I contains 33, L contains, A contains, B contains. So this is how you can see what are all the variables you have created. Hope you understood. Keep practicing. Meet you in the next video.